Yes, okay, thank you. Good evening all. Firstly, I am thanking the team IFPH to give the opportunity to share the experience of our All Kerala cycle ride. And then we decided, our cyclopers, the team of riding homeopaths, homeopathic doctors who all are riding a cycle. This is the cyclopaths group. We plan to conduct an event in All Kerala cycle ride for the purpose of to mark the importance of lifestyle diseases, to mark the importance of exercises and homeopathy in management of lifestyle diseases. In life to today, nowadays, more diseases in the world, more diseases affecting the people is lifestyle diseases. And more deaths occurring after these lifestyle diseases nowadays. And people and government authorities are not giving much importance to this type of diseases other than comparing to other viral diseases. So we need to give much importance and much awareness to the people and to the society regarding these lifestyle diseases. That's why we planning to All Kerala cycle ride from Kasaragod to the Trivandrum of Kerala. The main theme is to give awareness to the public, to the society, and more than other than the all doctors about this. What is the purpose of exercises? In exercises, cycling is the most important exercises, giving more useful things in lifestyle diseases. That's why from February 24th to 27th, we are planning to All Kerala cycle ride. And so many programs throughout these 4 days, so many programs like flag off and awareness classes, awareness programs, and notice distributions and pamphlet distributions and awareness classes and more receiving and wishing functions by different organizations like IHK, IHMA, QPHA, IFPH, GHF, and SAHIA, etc., etc. And also other public teams are giving more programs like that, the wishing programs and receiving programs by JCA and the Lions Club and the Rotary Clubs and the Society Common, the social media clubs, etc., etc. And after this program, throughout the program, we got so much people attention through the blogs, through the media attention, and et cetera, et cetera. Mainly to the nowadays, the main thing is the lifestyle disease management other than the treatment. We can give the treatment to the people, but we should aware the people about the preventive measures of the lifestyle diseases. In preventive measures of lifestyle diseases, the main thing is the exercises and the mental happiness. In that point, we are reaching to the cycling method. Cycling, about cycling, some persons are saying, if you need happiness, buy a cycle. Because cycling is a good exercise in the world, because in comparing to other exercises like jogging, like any gymnasia and other exercises, the cycling have more benefits, because we can give more happiness during our ride. We can give more explore. We can give more and much experiences after cycling. We cannot do in a situation like that, stress or mental struggle. We can't able to in a struggled situations. Only then that's why we can do the cycling, promoting the cycling other than other exercises. From starting there to the end there, from we are starting from Kasaragod and Kannur to Calicut, and then the Tirur and Kodungallur, then reach the Ernakulam, then to Alappuzha, Changanasheri, and Kollam Trivandrum. In this, throughout these places, we can able to explore more places and explore more doctors, and we can interact to more pupils and more society regarding this. And we are talked to a lot of doctors, lot of organizations, a lot of government authorities, and lot of people. And after this program, after this event, mainly 3 points I noticed after this ride. I noticed 3 points. After this ride, we got to aware about cycling to the public, to the doctors, and to all people to get more describe about the cycling. And second thing is a different experience after this cycle ride. I rided a lot of journeys via train, via bus, and via bike, car, etc., etc. But in all these journeys, all these experiences, I got wonderful experiences, and I got wonderful riding experience, wonderful happiness, and a most colorful experience after this cycle ride. And third point is, I got more confident after these challenging activities. These 3 points I got, and I want to share with all other pupils. And this cycling method and the homeopathy can do more reliable things in management of lifestyle diseases. And this just I talked about you the only the introduction part of our cycle ride. More details about this cycle ride and the cycle ride experiences will reveal by my friend and my co-rider Dr. Jamil Seth. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hisham. I think I'm audible.
Yes, you're audible, Doc.
Thank you, and thank you. And it's really great to talk here in the platform of IFPH, and it's very great to know that it's completed almost 180 days and plus. That's a big task what people has taken up. So, can I just share my slide, please?
Yes, please allow.
Yeah.
Yes, I have given the permission.
I think it's visible, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Thank you. As Dr. Hisham has told, we are mainly will be discussing on our plans and what we did for this All Kerala Cycle Ride. Okay. So at first we created cyclopaths, that is cycling homeopaths, because this main theme of this ride was not only to educate people, to educate doctors too. Because normally what we do is we tell patients to do an exercise or do some exercise, but we are not aware of what exercise to be done and how it is to be done. Mainly if you take cycling, we have a lot of benefits in cycling, like none of the joints are weight bearing. There is no chances of this one osteoarthritis or something like that. But if you are not selecting a correct cycle, or if you are not selecting a perfect size according to your height, and the initial phase when my childhood or maybe your old childhood, you have seen that cycles are all same size, and we used to ride it accordingly. But here now we have different sizes like extra small, small, medium, large, extra large. Everything is available in cycling. So automatically, you, a doctor, must be knowing all these things so that you can bring this notice to the people, to the patients, so that they'll be getting the complete benefit out of it. So there was two aims for us: to educate doctors, to educate public. Okay. In this, we named this event as Cycle of Health, because we believe that a cycle or an exercise can bring health more stronger. So we have many sponsors, out of which our main sponsors were Similia India and Herring Pharma, who completely they came forward to help us out with this this event. And the organizers who supported us was IHME, QPHA, IHK, SAHYA, GHF, and IFPH. All these people were really ready for us, who were coming eagerly came forward to help us with this innovative idea. First of all, let me say one thing, that is, this cycling around Kerala is not a big deal. That I can assure you, cycling around Kerala, it is only 550 kilometers that will be completed in 4 days. It's not really a big deal. Anyone among you can do this. I can bet you anyone among you can complete this easily. Maybe you may take 1 or 2 days extra, maybe 5 or 6 days. Still, you can do this. If I can do it, anyone can do it. That's what I believe in. This is a jersey for our event with all our sponsors, because a jersey will bring attention of the public. And what we did is, in the backside of jersey, we have included that is homeopathy for lifestyle diseases. And I can tell you, if at least one person read this and get motivated, it is a success for us. That's what I believe in, at least one person. But I'm sure it's not one person who has come noticed, and many people has come and talked to us. They had collected our numbers regarding all this. And what we did is we told the doctors who were locally available so that they can go and consult than us. Day one, we started with IHK Kanjangad. IHK Kanjangad and JCA Kanjangad came forward for the flag of ceremony. And Dr. Vivek and Dr. Nidath, who has come forward and helped us to get a chief guest like B.V. Remeshan, who is the ex-municipal chairman of Kanjangad municipality. He flagged off for our event by morning 7 o'clock. Then we reached Kannur, and with the help of JCI Kannur Handloom City, we gave many pamphlets, that is government pamphlets, to many of the people. And we mainly focused on auto rickshaw drivers, so that because they are the people who reaches more people, giving a pamphlet to a single person may not be much useful as we give to an auto rickshaw driver. So it can reach more of people. And we have visited the government dispensary. To my greatest surprise, government is having a wonderful infrastructure and facilities for this lifestyle diseases, and which is not known to us. There are Ayushman Bhava Kendras throughout Kerala where they deal with lifestyle diseases. And it was really wonderful to talk with them. And there was Sunilal sir, who is a state coordinator, and Dr. Shibipi Varghese, who is a coordinator of Kannur district. They explained us all the details, what they do in their dispensaries. And we had a great welcome and a second phase flag off by QPHA and Kannur Cycling Club. Here, what we did, what our strategy was, to include more of public groups than homeopathy groups, because homeopathy groups are helping with us. Plus, we have to add more public groups so that it reaches publics. We want homeopathy to reach more of public, so we concentrate more of public. So Kannur Cycling Club came forward, and they were there, and there was a doctor, Mr. Shaheen, who is the cycle mayor of Kannur. There is a post called cycle mayor in each and every district who works for the development of cycling system. And there was a good, very good coverage of news by Kannur Vision. That is which has very big footage they have taken us, and it has covered a long area of Kannur. And when we reached Calicut, there were JCI Calicut who were ready to welcome us. And all these things, when a JCI come, at least one or two, here you can see only 3 people. But understand one thing is, this is the COVID era, so we tried maximum to reduce people, but it to reach more people, because these 3 people will go back and send these photos and awareness things to their respective groups. So for example, JCI Calicut is having more than 150 members together, to the core of JCI members. So 150 plus people has known about this, and this goes to their Facebook where they have more than 1,000 followers. And IHMA Calicut came forward to welcome us. in Calicut Beach. And here, when we came to the beach, automatically the people will be getting noticed as we are in jersey and cycle. Automatically, and the wonderful thing about cycling or cycle, what I felt is we go slowly, right? So automatically, other people can stop in and talk to us. It's different from we travel in a bike or a car or a lorry or a bus. Generally different. So day two started with the Team Malabar Riders, the cycle club of Calicut. It's a cycling mother club of mine. They came forward to welcome me. This only the members of three members were shown in the photo, but there were a lot of members in between who joined and left us in between. So this was the thing. Second day started by 5:30 in the early morning from Calicut, from my house. And we started with the cycling club. And we had a very warm welcome by IHK Malappuram. Aslam and Shihad, many of the doctors came forward, and Jaffer doctor, everyone came forward, and it was a really great event for us. Where they went, IHK Malappuram has gone live in Facebook, reaching many more people together. So we were focusing like that, to reach more of people, focus on Facebook lives and all these things. Second, we visited IHK Kodungallur, where Mubarak ji and Anwar doctor, many doctors came forward and to welcome us. And this event happened in a cycle shop, a newly started cycle shop, that is Bharat Cycles. So what here happens is, we got a chance to introduce homeopathy to the people in Bharat Cycles, and we got a chance to introduce cycles to homeopathy doctors. These two things happened in IHK Kodungallur. That is a wonderful thing what I felt, and I felt happy about. And Bharat Cycle Kodungallur has taken up very seriously our event, and they have gifted us many jerseys of their cycle shops. And it shows the impact what we were able to create in their store. And the day ended up in the Highway Hotel, where the IHMA state president came forward, Ganesh sir came forward and welcomed us. And we stayed there in a Highway Hotel in Ernakulam the second day. The bitter part of this ride, what we felt was that these 4 days was the hottest day in Kerala. All other days was medium hot, but these 4 days was the most hot, and government even had declared sunburns on these days, UV radiations, all these things that day. But we were unfortunate to have that, but still our willpower didn't stop us, and we came forward. Day three was really exciting for us, as we met Mr. Ibadur Rahman. Maybe you people have known him. He is a YouTube influencer, one of the first YouTube vlogger in Kerala. He is having more than 7 lakh followers. He visited us. He has taken up many videos of us. That videos still to be published in YouTube and Facebook. That was with the help of Dr. Nusaif, who helped us to have him here. And Dr. Nusaif is also a rider in our Cyclopus group. And meanwhile, we met another person from Aluva, Mr. Anoop. And this thing of cycling is, we create friendship between us. Mr. Anoop, I met him for the first time in the day three. And what happened is, day five, when I was returning back, he insisted, or he pressurized me to go to his house and had the lunch. So that bonding was created between the people. That is a wonderful thing of cycling, when you create bonds between people. Then the other thing, what attractive thing we came forward is, Dr. Ashwin has shared our photos in Facebook, which was liked by Hybe Eden. Hybe Eden, you may be knowing, he's an MP of Kochi. He has liked this event and came forward to help us with it. So this is the impact what we create, we were able to create in the public. And the third day, we had a IHMA Alapi and Alapi Cycle Club, Alapi Bikers Club, not a cycle club, Bikers Club, Dr. Deepu and others, who came forward and flagged off our second strain of our travel. That was flagged off by Mr. Dr. Joy, who is the MD of HomeCo. And we were happy, we were lucky enough to meet the collector of RIP, the Alexander IPS, to give away a memorando. That is, we had a small idea in our mind, that is to create more open gyms, open tracks, open jogging tracks, open cycle tracks, all these things for the public so that people can come forward. Because as this COVID has made people to lock down or stay at home, it's high time to come out now with a safer way. That is not a risky way like other exercise or something like that. But cycling is always a safer way because if you know that cycling, if you're doing a cycling, you know, no need of wearing a mask because already you are there with a social distance. So automatically you are safe enough and can ride and have a healthy exercise. So we were lucky enough to meet Alexander sir. Then there are Kachi Mema Jamaat, that is my family members of LAP. They came forward to welcome us. So all these things came up and all these people take away their photos and go to their groups. So automatically now this world of COVID or post-COVID era is a social platform life, right? Even now we can see 180 plus days is happening in a sitting at home, you are having a conference. Before it's not possible or it was not thought of. We can only go weekly to Sunday, some conference halls, and we used to conduct conferences, and it was very limited to the people around us. But now it is worldwide, we are able to connect. That's the beautiful thing of social media, and luckily we were able to connect it more and help it out. And Changanashiri, they did a really big task by connecting all the organizations, and I should it was really a hats off performance by Dr. S.G. Biju. He single-mandedly coordinated all these organizations. This I really felt what is a homeopathy doctor must be more of social animal. He is really being a very social, connected to all the organizations. If you just see the list of the organization, it was IHK, IHMA, QPHA, Sahya, JCI, Rotary Club, Lions Club, Changanashiri Junction. That is, the Changanashiri Junction is a bigger platform of FB group. And a dialysis center. This happened in front of a dialysis center, and there were really good news coverage by ACV Changanashiri. And this event was one of the best event which happened in throughout our ride. And this has reached more of public. That's what I should say. Because Rotary, Lions, JCI, all these people has come forward, so automatically it reached more of public. And at the day three ends, we visited Nasir, that is a Nas Bike Zone, a vlogger, a cycling blogger. He's having a good number of subscribers at Kayangulam. We had a small talk with him, and he has taken videos of our event or what our aims is. So automatically what we are focusing is we are keen enough to meet all these bloggers because these bloggers can take into the public. We are mainly focused to reach all these things to public. Then day four started very energetically. That was by JCI Attingal and Swastia Health Center. There was a black belt camp going on in Attingal. We visited there with the help of Dr. Deepu Dev. And there were very good performance by the black belt honors. And we were able to talk to them basic on this homeopathy and lifestyle diseases with the help of exercise. All this is we were able to talk to them, and I think it has reached them and reached more public out. Then at the ending ceremony at Trivandrum, we had a warm welcome from IFPH, and which is the organization now here, and IHK, and the cycle mayor of Trivandrum has visited us, and the students of Nemam College. These people has come forward and welcomed us, and it was a really good finishing ceremony. And to mark with the free finishing ceremony, we again visited another vlogger, that is K Cyclopedia. He's one of the biggest cycling blogger of Kerala, even he has taken our video and already has published the theme in his YouTube channel. And to finish it off, the IHMA Trivandrum gave a very warm welcome and a great dinner for us at where DMO has visited us and talked to us. And even here, there was a Facebook Live going on to reach more of people. And finishing touch was by Raj Bakes. That is, this shows the impact of public, or this shows what we were able to create. This is one, Ms. Ranjini of Trivandrum. She visited me by seeing my Facebook post. She visited, not only visited, she is a nutritionist. She baked a healthy nutritionist cake for us. And she visited us at IHMA Center and gifted us all these gifts. So this is what the public, even public, has taken this into their mind. And this was our journey of 4 days traveling from Kanyanga to Trivandrum. And this is what I have to tell you. This is what I was telling from the starting. If I can, anybody can. This was me 3 or 4 years back, and I was able to cut down nearly 42 kgs from my body with the help of cycling and homeopathy. And I myself made it a brand of Slim In Homeopathy, where I treat people with a diet, medicine and exercise, a combination. What I believe is none of one system can cure. It is not that medicine only can reduce obesity. It's not only diet can reduce obesity. It's not exercise alone. It must be a combo, because if when you put it with one system, it is much difficult, and there are more chances of people to go in a wrong direction. When all the three directions are closed, automatically it will go in a correct, the fourth direction, which is a proper direction and which can be of more of benefit to the people. And let me just tell you a story to conclude. When I was coming back, I met these two, I should say, young people. That is, one is Mr. Johnson. He is 72 years. And second person is Mr. Salim. He is 65 years. I should say he is more younger than me. They were riding their cycle from Kochi to Kanyakumari, and they were returning back. And I can say the 72-year-old Johnson sir was at least riding a gear cycle, but Salim sir was riding the very old cycle, which you can see in the photograph behind. That was 30-year-old cycle, which is very old, which is very heavy cycle too. He was riding on it, and he was able to complete this event. And to my surprise, when I talked with him, he is an ultra marathon runner. Ultra marathon runner means the Salim sir, he used to run for 72 kilometers at his age of 65. And I here struggled to run 1 or 2 kilometers. So just imagine what age is. Age is just a number. That's what I should say. It's all willpower and how we train. And these two people have never heard of any lifestyle diseases, I should say. They were never heard of diabetes or hypertension, obesity, nothing. They were real heroes, what I saw them with. And they were traveling with a message of promote cycling. And I should say, it's hats off to them. And by then, I should conclude my talk. And if you have anything, I have a small YouTube channel, that is Life Roots, where I am uploading each and every day what happened in this travel. Plus, all my health videos are uploaded here with my weight loss plans, weight loss tips, and about Arsenicum album in the corona. All these things, views, everything is uploaded in this YouTube channel. Just go forward, and if you are interested, please consider subscribing. This is all from my side. Thank you, IFPH, and to invite us. And let's, anything to discuss, I am ready to discuss. Thank you.